You know, I am so fascinated by the psychology of everything that's happening within this show, and I'm curious, as you play these characters, does it change the way you perceive things that are happening in the news? Like, when you see murders in the news or, like, things that are happening disturbing in real life, do you think differently about it now that you've played
Absolutely.
These characters?
You know, when Stephen Paddock killed 58 people in Las Vegas a couple of weeks ago, the first thing I did was call John Douglas.
Really?
And John Douglas, who wrote the book Mindhunter, that our show is based on, a famous FBI profiler. Yeah, because I was really curious what were the questions that he would be asking if he were there.
What did he say?
You know, he said that it's the opposite of creating a profile, because when you're creating a profile, we don't know who the killer is, and we're trying through process of elimination, you know, to try to find the most likely category of person that he comes from. Whereas in this situation, we know who the guy is. We just don't know why he did it. Do you see what I mean? So it's about trying to figure out the why of it all, trying to figure out what his relationship was with those victims. What did they represent to him? Why did he choose those particular people? And, you know, what were the warning signs, you know, leading up to him committing this crime? So all of those questions, and I find that, you know, now whenever I see an incident like this, these are the things that I start thinking about right away.
That's so fascinating. Does this take a toll on you emotionally, though? I mean, obviously you're dealing with a pretty crazy subject matter. Specifically, these interviews you're doing with these serial killers is pretty intense. I mean, those scenes with the co-ed killer are just phenomenal to watch. But they're so interesting, but it's so disturbing what he did. Does it take a toll on you when you go home at the end of the day?
The only thing I remember, like, when I first sat down with David and he was talking about the show, and he said, can you not get sick for a year because you have to be there every day? And so can you, you know, wake up early and stay late and do that over the course of what ended up being 10 months? So for me, it was the kind of marathon of showing up every day and knowing the lines and, like, being able to give all of myself to it. But I found the work and the intensity of the scenes and the intensity of the subject matter incredibly interesting and exciting to play. I mean, those scenes that we have with the serial killers are so interesting.
Yeah.
And there's so much going on and endless possibilities of ways you can play certain things. So I actually was on fire doing them. I just love doing it.
This is a random filmmaking question, but there's a great scene in the, I think it's in the first episode, where you're at a concert, you meet your girlfriend for the first time, and you guys are just, like, having this conversation while this band is playing.
Yeah.
I mean, he did something similar in Social Network when they were at the club, like, talking back. I think it was Timberlake and Eisenberg.
Yeah.
Is that weird to shoot a scene when there's that much noise happening?
Yeah, well, what's weird about it is there isn't actually noise.
Whoa, because,
yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Some when you have to dance?
when you're dancing, like, there's no music?
Actually, in the scene in the bar where I first meet her, they had everybody talking so we could achieve a level of vocal loudness.
Yeah.
But then in the scene with the band, because of sound, we had, like, the music playing in our ear, but we had to talk like this and pretend that... So that's what was weird about it, is you're, like, pretending that you're talking over a band, but there's actually nothing happening?
Yeah. You know, I'm
but there is a music when you have to dance. Like, if you watch people, like, doing stuff and talking, they're just...
It's like us in this room right
now.
So
weird. Yeah. As a big David Fincher fan, I know that, like, on films, he'll do multiple takes, like, up to 100 from what I've heard on, like, Social Network and things like that. When he's doing a TV show, is it similar? Are you doing multiple takes of every single scene like he normally does?
Yeah.
Absolutely, yeah. And he does, and he'll do a lot of setups and then a lot of takes within each setup. One of the unique things about Mindhunter is that we have long scenes that you won't see on other television shows.
Yeah.
We don't have to cut to commercial. We have 10, 12, 14-page scenes.
Mm.
And so I think that one of the things that he does in order to keep those really riveting in the way that they are, the interviews with the serial killers, is you do a lot of coverage. You get a lot of angles and do a lot of takes within those angles, and performances change, and he refines things. He's very meticulous, so he just keeps kind of making little adjustments along the way until he finally gets what he wants.
But what he also does is he knows exactly what he wants, and so everyone's prepared, and so you're able to do so many takes within, like, a working day, because that's where all your time goes.
Mm.
Whereas often you'll be on a set waiting, you know, an hour or so for a lighting change. And
yeah, for your lead actor to show up.
Yeah.
Were you late one day, sir?
He was never late once.
Not once.
He's never late
once.
Knock on wood.
What listen, there was talk before the first season came out that David was talking about this being like a 5-year plan or a 5-season plan.
We're hopeful.
Right. I wanted to know, is that still the thing where it's a 5-season plan?
We want it to be. So any pull that you have. Yeah, you know, I mean, that's was David's intention in the beginning. And I know that, you know, it's been a very rewarding experience for all of us making the show. Audiences seem to really love the show. There seems to be a tremendous amount of excitement and anticipation for the next season. And yeah, I mean, I personally would love to do season 3, 4, and 5.
Looking back on season 1, well, actually, I want to ask you about season 2. Talk a little about the challenges of the season and maybe what was the stuff that, since you had all 9 scripts, that you were really excited to do, and maybe something that you saw in the script, you're like, oh, this is going to be a really, really awful day on set.
Well, speaking to the mothers and the Atlanta Child murders was pretty heartbreaking. The scene, which you've seen, right?
Yes. Yeah.
Anna said earlier, you're... This season, really getting to see the victim side of the story in a way that you didn't maybe necessarily in the first season. And so that was really intense. And I didn't, in the first season, everyone would always ask us what was, you know, is it hard to go to sleep at night, or do you get demons of the, and I never had anything like that. But I do remember on the day with the mothers when they were talking about, and they were crying, and as these amazing actresses, that was the most sort of, that was the day that stuck with me the most for sure.
For you guys?
A couple of things that come later, I think.
For me, it's definitely the tension that's created in Bill's life, because he's kind of being pulled in 2 different directions.
Well, that's what I was going to say, but I just...
Okay. Between my responsibilities as a husband and a father, and also my professional responsibilities as an FBI agent, you know, investigating the Atlanta Child murders with my partner.
That was also a beautiful, I don't know if it was in the first, that was a beautiful scene when you meet with the victim, the live victim in the back of the car, too.
Right.
Well, I don't remember. That was pretty harrowing to watch.
Yeah,
actually.
The only survivor of an attack by BTK.
Yeah, I can't imagine
Dennis Rader,
shooting that.
The bind, torture, kill. Which it's Ross Strangler, you know. It's a very powerful scene, but there are a lot of powerful scenes in season 2. It's a great season. We're really proud of it.